This week, Speaker Robert Rivas named Assemblymember Isaac Bryan of Los Angeles as Majority Leader. At just 31, Bryan is among the youngest legislators and now one of the top leaders. Isaac Bryan, welcome to The Issue Is for the very first time, and congrats on the new gig.
Alex, it's good to be with you. Thank you for having me.
So, Majority Leader, what does that role mean to you?
It means that we've got a lot of work to do for all of California. It means that we have a Democratic supermajority, and the Speaker has entrusted me, my colleagues have entrusted me to be a part of helping guide that in a direction that uplifts everybody. But I wouldn't be this without Speaker Rivas, so I want to give a shout out to him and looking forward to his leadership.
Yeah, and he's brand new into that job. We're going to talk to him next week, actually, here on The Issue Is. But in the meantime, I want to talk more about you, because I think you have such a remarkable life story, like it's going to be a movie someday. So I should start optioning the rights or something. Let's talk about your beginnings, because for a lot of people, this is an introduction to your story, because you do not have the typical story.
No, I don't. Politics is not like a family thing or a pathway I expected. My mother was 16 years old. She survived a rape. She got pregnant with me. She lived in deep poverty. She couldn't keep me, gave me up. I went to two different foster homes. My second foster home, as an infant, I was adopted in the Bryan family. They did foster care for 26 years. They adopted 9 of us. I had hundreds of foster siblings growing up in the Bryan family. We moved a lot to make ends meet. I went to a lot of different schools. I've seen the way systems fail folks. I've seen the way systems have failed my siblings, my foster siblings, and to be in a position now to be able to change those systems and make them the kind of civic infrastructures that allow for everyone to thrive is an opportunity I'm looking forward to.
And school at first was challenging for you, right?
Incredibly challenging. I mean, I failed out of middle school. I'm famous in my third high school for getting an F minus in my English class. I felt disconnected from education. I thought it was not matching up with the lived experience I was having.
And then somehow you're able to figure it out, end up at UCLA, and graduate first in your class?
Top of my master's program. If I'm being completely honest, the same class I got an F minus in English is the classroom I watched Barack Obama sworn in as president. The next year I was government student of the year. And so there was seeing yourself, representation, it makes a difference. And so to be in a position as majority leader with the kind of life history I've had, I know it's representation for a lot of people across California.
Well, and now you have an opportunity to bring some of those voices to Sacramento. A lot of voices, frankly, the foster system, that don't have great lobbyists, right? Because they don't have a lot of money. Those people are left behind. What are some of the big policy proposals or policy priorities you have now in this job because of that lived experience?
No, absolutely. When you've seen the way systems have failed families and failed children, it gives you a different perspective on the urgency and how important this is. One bill in particular this year I want to share is AB 1512. Counties, for children in the child welfare system who have lost their parents, those children are due survivor benefits. It's different than the child welfare allocations counties normally get. That money belongs to the young people. But right now, California counties are keeping that money. They're siphoning it off to offset the cost of the system. Other states don't do this. It's bipartisan. Nebraska, Maryland, and so many others. Texas is trying. We're going to set that money aside in bank accounts for those young children, and we're going to do it this year.
You know, you're young, 31 years old, and now you are one of the leaders of a lot of folks who have very different experiences than you, look different than you. How is it leading a group of people, many of whom are in their 50s and 60s, when you're 31?
Well, change has always been intergenerational, right? It's been multiracial. It's people who come from rural areas and densely populated areas. It's about love, compassion, and uplifting the humanity in all of us. And that's what I'm going to try to do as majority leader. And I'm grateful to my colleagues for their trust and my ability to do that.
And part of it also, and we're seeing some pictures of you out in the community, is literally getting out in the community. You say, like, just going to chicken dinners is not the way to do this. Talk about your approach and maybe what politicians can learn from your generation.
Yeah, so I came up as a community organizer in a very real way, trying to organize my neighbors, trying to organize LA County, trying to push for the changes that we needed. And when I became an elected official, it occurred to me that oftentimes that's a license to abandon your organizing days. And for me, that's not the case. I go the same places I used to go. I say hi to the same neighbors I've always said hi to. And I know that real power isn't held by me or my colleagues. It's held by the community. I never forget that.
Yeah, I've been out in Leimert Park with you, and you seem to know everybody there, and they seem to have a lot of love for you there. So the reason that this is happening is because there has been this leadership change. Robert Rivas is now in charge as Speaker. And there was a fight within the Democratic Party. Anthony Rendon, who we just had on the show, wanted to stay as Speaker, and there was a pushback to get him out of there. What is the difference now for the average Californian with Speaker Robert Rivas versus Speaker Anthony Rendon? What does that mean for their life?
Yeah, to be clear, Anthony Rendon was an incredible speaker. I have just incredibly fond memories. I remember when his mother passed away, he came back to the legislature the next day and testified on SB2, our police decertification bill. But for Robert Rivas, Rob grew up in farm worker housing. Rob is the kind of, Speaker Rivas is the kind of legislator who shouldn't exist in California, certainly shouldn't be leading the assembly. And when I say shouldn't, it's because these institutions weren't designed for people at the margins to become their leaders. So for him leading it, it means that there's going to be an emphasis on the people who have historically been left out. We're going to lift from the bottom and make sure that everybody rises.
And is there an example of and maybe a policy change that didn't happen before that's going to happen now?
Well, since we're only a week in, I can't say that the policy shift has immediately happened, but there is a culture shift happening right now, one where all legislators are seen and heard as a representation of all of California.
Let's talk a little bit more about you. What do you think is the lesson that all of us can learn from your mother?
That if you lead with compassion and you love without restriction, you can improve the conditions of life for all of those around you. And for my mother, she's has spent decades doing that for children in the child welfare system. And for the nine of us that she's adopted, she's one of my heroes. And I continually learn from her.
You're not a father yet, although you are a dog dad.
Correct.
And your dog, I think, is bigger than me. And I'm 6'5". I mean, this dog is enormous. tell us a little bit about your baby here.
So Darius is my Great Dane. Me and my fiance Lamara. He is our child. He goes with us around town. He campaigns with us. He stays at hotels with us. He's every bit as much of a child as I could have right now. He's also just the biggest goofball. I enjoy seeing him every day.
How do you like fit him into stuff?
He actually curls up real nicely, like you can see there. He's a great cuddler. And I know for Lamara, when I'm on the road, you know, he knows, and then he crawls up into bed and fills my spot because we're about the same size.
He's your replacement. Up next, we're going to play a game called Personal Issues, which I think you've seen here on the show before. But as we go to break, you know we like to play music. And I don't know if you saw this, but Billboard came out with their list of the greatest rap groups of all time.
Okay.
What do you think is number one on the list? What would be number one on your list? Rap group. So this isn't an individual. Rap group of all time.
Greatest rap group of all. Well, I mean, we're in Los Angeles, so you know NWA has got to be high. Outkast has got to be in there.
NWA was top five, but Outkast was number one.
Here we go.
So we're going to break with some Outkast. Your chance to dance. We'll be right back. That is Baldwin Hills Democrat Isaac Bryan working at an ice cream parlor when he was younger. Now, as of this week, he is the majority leader of the California Assembly. When you were doing that, yeah. Was there any part of you that envisioned you could be doing this?
Not at all.
Yeah.
The journey is everything, and I'm incredibly grateful.
And what do you think sort of are the lessons that you learned, though, from that experience, which is not one that most legislators have?
I think just staying humble and doing hard work, doing everything you do with excellence, whether it's scooping ice cream or legislating. You do it with a pure heart and to the best of your ability, and good things can happen.
Does that skill set still remain? I mean, do you ever do that for your girlfriend or anything?
It's like riding a bike. I can do it right now.
Yeah, okay. Next time you're here, we're bringing out ice cream, and we're going to do an ice cream thing. All right, but in the meantime, we're going to have some fun, though. We're going to play a game called Personal Issues. This is where we put 30 seconds up on the clock. We get to know some of your cultural favorites. I think you're going to be especially good at this.
Okay.
All right, here we go. What is your favorite TV show of all time?
The West Wing.
Oh. Best. A favorite band or musical artist?
Tupac.
Tupac. Who's your favorite athlete of all time?
Kobe. Rest in peace.
Favorite actor?
Oh, favorite actor. Denzel.
Favorite book of all time?
The Color of Water.
Best thing about being a Californian?
The people.
Favorite way to relax?
Playing basketball.
And who is your role model?
My mother.
Your mother. And one more time, as we remind people who may just be tuning in, she had how many foster kids?
Nearly 200 and adopted 9 of us.
And what more do you think that our world can learn from that experience, and in terms of what more we can do to improve the foster experience, because those are the most vulnerable people among us? 50% of people in foster care end up homeless.
Right.
What more can we do on that front?
Or incarcerated. I mean, there's a lot we can do on that front, but the lessons I learned from my mother, you know, a lot of people ask me, oh, as majority leader, you have the power to fix everything now, and that's not the case. The power lies in all of us, and no matter where you are or what you're doing, you can play a part, and my mother definitely played her part. Now the rest of us have to do ours.
Very nice. All right, well, next time you come on, we're gonna play Tupac, and we're gonna have some ice cream, but in the meantime, I'm playing some Pharrell. And this is Feeling Brand New, because the legislature is feeling brand new with new leadership. Thank you so much, Isaac Bryan. Great to see you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Alex.
Here's your chance to dance it out. We'll be back with more of The Issue Is after this. This is a guy with some real moves. We're also going to do basketball. We're going to do that sometime, too. We actually have a hoop out back. So, yeah.